Latex 560 and 570 have a new autoload process. And the new autoload process is more refined, and it is more innovative than we've had in the past. The new loading process is somewhat automated in that when you load the roll automatically, the pinch rollers, back at the pinch rollers, are actually going to make slight adjustments to try to correct for skew. So when you load the material, if it's loaded a little off, the printer by itself will take the material and then shift the media until the skew is correct, and then it will improve upon the skew, and so it is much more likely that it will get skew right the first time. Now, you can still manually load the printer. That is, there is a way to choose an assisted manual load or an auto load. To some degree, that's going to depend on the media, and some of that is a personal preference. It kind of depends what you're running. If you're running something that's very amenable to the auto load feature, then by all means, use the auto load. But if you're running material that seems difficult through the auto load, then feel free to revert to the assisted manual load. When you do the assisted manual load, you're going to select it on the button here to load the media, and you choose assisted manual load, and then you hit continue. Now, what it's going to ask you to do is it's going to ask me to lift this door up. You lift the door because we're going to try to open up that space so when we feed the media, it doesn't get stuck there. You know, we have to keep the opening fairly small, and we have to seal this because the idea is that we're trying to bring air through here so that we can collect the condensation and then deposit it elsewhere. We want to clear this area of all that excess condensation. That's the intention of the new curing units. So the door has to open to do that. Then the next thing you're going to do is feed the media in. Now, I have a long-standing preference, and this is my preference. I'll explain it to you in a little bit. What I tend to do when I take the media is I roll it out a bit, and I cut a little smile into it. I've done this in an earlier video. I'm going to cut a curve into it so it looks like a smile for two purposes. One, it feeds through the printer easily. It tends not to get caught on the pinch rollers back there. Now, when you've lifted this door and told it that you're going to do an assisted manual load, it has lifted the pinch rollers automatically. There's no more lever on the side here for a 500 series printer. It's not available that way. You lift this up, it lifts the pinch rollers, and everything's automatic. Then I cut my smile. The other reason I like the smile, in addition to the fact that it glides through the pinch rollers a little easier without ever getting stuck, is I use that apex of the curve to put a nice piece of 2-inch tape, and then I can put it on the take-up roll with one piece of tape, and I get it on there really quickly. So if I'm putting it on the take-up roll while it's printing, that single piece of tape is going to be very easy to put on, and it's going to be very accurate, and it prevents me from torquing it by trying to get two pieces of tape on, and you get one on in front of the other, and it causes the material to drift. With a single piece of tape, it's very easy with that smile. So I cut that smile so that it kind of goes right towards the center, and this is a preference. You can load it without doing this. Set this aside. And now it travels through the printer right easily, and then I'm going to tape it to the take-up. So this is my preference for loading the machine. At this point, I simply get low. If you're not quite so tall, it's a little easier. You feed this right through the bottom and just kind of give it a little momentum, and away it goes. Comes right down to the front of the printer. I line it up with the edge here, make sure it's nice and straight. Close the door, nice and tight. Hit OK. Now it's going to check the skew. Going to determine if the skew meets the expectations, and the skew can be adjusted for how tight or loose you want the tolerance to be prior to loading. So if it's a very tight skew, it's going to insist that it be very, very accurate, and it's a very loose skew, then it's going to give you a little more leeway. In this case, it appears to like the skew. I'm going to tell it that it's an adhesive vinyl, I'm going to tell it what kind of adhesive vinyl it is. I'm going to hit continue. The printer is now going to check the winding direction automatically. And then you have to reach your next decision. The next decision is going to be, where do you want to place this media? On this printer, this decision can be kind of important. If you roll the media back, where you might say place it on a 360, where you have all the vacuum holes filled and you've got the media just going into the first opening, with this printer, you may need to open the door to start printing. That is, you don't want to have the media come down with this door closed and get stuck in this narrow opening. And that can happen. So rather than that, have that happen, you start printing. I'm going to hit continue with current skew just for this purpose, but the machine read that it felt that the skew needed to be a little tighter, and you can certainly do that. It's now evaluating the width. But back to this issue here. If you decide that you want to keep the door closed and start printing, then my recommendation on some medias, not necessarily all, but say on an adhesive vinyl, I would probably have it come out past this door a little bit. That is my preference. Now, if I'm out past this door, the distance from here to the take-up on this printer is very short. And I might be inclined to just put it on the take-up roll at that point. But I would certainly bring it past the door. Now, if you want to open the door, you can bring it back further, but you've got to remember to come back over here after it clears the open door and shut the door again, because you don't want to run the whole print with the door open, because it defeats the purpose and undermines the efficiency of the curing unit. So it kind of depends what you're running and then how attentive you are to come over here and make sure the door is closed at the right time. So my preference, because I can't ever remember to come over here and close the door, is to have it hang out a little bit off the front edge. And because I have a curl in it, I'm going to leave this a little longer, and then these edges are just barely peeking out. This is where I prefer to run this printer. Keep in mind, the 560 and 570 is designed ideally, especially the 570 with a bulk system, to print longer runs. You're going to be doing a lot of printing. So you load a roll on and you run a good part of that roll and then you put another roll on, or you burn the entire roll altogether. It's designed to print more volume. It's a higher productivity printer. And having a little out the front is not a big deal for me. Now, if you can remember, then roll this back. Waste a little less media. Bring it back towards the platen. I still prefer to keep the media across the platen and have the front edge of this come into the first opening a little bit, open this up, send the job over. Once the job is over, it'll start printing, and as it comes out the front, then come over here and shut the door, and then put it on the take-up reel as it's printing. But just keep in mind, if you try to print back at the pinch rollers, you have two openings to clear. First one is right there, and there's always a potential it can kind of get stuck there, and if it does, it will kind of feed on itself and you can have a head strike. The second possibility is that it gets kind of stuck along here a little bit and you're printing and it's scratching along there because it's not quite getting out through the narrow opening. Each of those is a possibility, and I just want you to be aware of it so you can make a rational decision on where you want to place your media and how you want to run the printer. I have my preferences. Other people have their preferences based upon their media and based upon their expectations. But I wanted to make it clear how this kind of works, what some of your loading options are, so you can view this printer properly. My preference, again, is I tend to shut this, roll it forward, and then start printing. But I won't do that necessarily on all medias. I'll take them on a case-by-case basis. If you want to use an autoload and the material is amenable for it, by all means, please feel free. Okay, so that's loading the 560 and 570. A little bit of my own personal preferences involved. And again, those are personal preferences on our new 560. Fantastic machine, great process, very easy to do. Next, the take-up roll.